We had our board meeting yesterday, and we're working on the whole concept of transformational partners. And so the word tithing keeps coming up, and the six board members have all had very positive experiences with tithing and feel strongly that to exclude that word is probably problematic for them, and that they want a little bit of clarity on is the word being excluded just to fill in for something else, or is it we're not teaching tithing properly? So tell me more about that.
So what you're experiencing is a natural. The established core is aligned with the concept of tithing. It's just that the tithing as a funding model doesn't work. Right now, the problem is not the tithing so much as the way in which we frame it. We frame it as tithing to where you're spiritually fed. Most folks cannot differentiate tithing from the dynamic of being spiritually fit. So the dynamic itself, therefore, creates a kind of dysfunction within ministry in the context of, if that's our funding model, we're trying to get people to tithe, and we're promoting tithe to where you're spiritually fed, that means that we are the source of their spiritual nourishment. Okay, and we're also teaching them to look outside of themselves for the source of their spiritual nourishment in that practice. That is what I believe is to be the fundamental problem of how we teach tithing. We teach tithing as a matter of acknowledging our increase, but we're acknowledging the increase that comes externally. And in other words, I have to be fed. And so I may wake up some Sunday morning and say, I don't feel spiritually fed today. Reverend Moe's off for game, so I think I'm going to cut my tithe in half, because if it's all about me feeling spiritually fed and I don't feel that way, then I have a legitimate cause to withhold when I believe things are out of integrity. So therefore, the funding model, the tithing practice, then becomes a manipulative tool when people all of a sudden discover there's something that they dislike about what's going on. That's one problem. The other problem, as I mentioned, is that we inadvertently teach people to look outside of themselves for the source of their well-being. And that is malpractice. They should always, we should teach them to look within themselves for their well-being. The problem is that when they look within, all they see is their shit. But if they look within and we're talking them to uncover their sense of well-being and worth, and when they recognize that, then the practice can become tithing as source. So it's no longer about me looking outside of myself. It's me deciding what I want to see flourish in this world. I, through the activity of tithing as source, can discover that I am empowered to make a difference in my world. I don't have to sit back and just let things happen. I can give into the intent to bring forth a greater good. So in my guidance as being the prophet and recognizing that while tithing has been a blessing for many of the established core in our congregations, young people think it's a gimmick. And in the context of reality, in terms of our religion, the institution of religion or Christianity, it is a gimmick. It's a funding gimmick. So we have to educate people to help them understand why it is critical, integral to the future, because the younger generation is our future. These shifts that I'm calling forth are to help the established community develop the younger demographic, because if it's stuck in its sacred cow that we can't let go of tithing, then it is disabling the capacity of it to welcome the generation that has to come. Otherwise, there's an expiration date. So what if we were to differentiate the funding of our church from the spiritual practice of tithing and just teach the spiritual practice of tithing, but tithe as source? Help people shift out of looking outside of themselves for evidence of their worth, and therefore we have to tithe to that. Instead, discover what value there is in me being source unto that which is inviting me to co-create. And so ultimately, we want to teach this principle, not so much in the context of tithing as source, but in the context of ownership, in the context of we all own the intent to create a ministry that has as its takeaway, if you hang with us, your life will be transformed and you'll want to make your world a better place. We want people to fund that intentionality independent of spiritual practice of tithing. Well, we're not suggesting we take that away. We're rebranding things so that the younger people can align with our community and we can align with their demographic. That's the reason why we've taken church out of our name and gone to spiritual center. And you explained that. The reason why we did that was because there's an allergy to that. Well, there's an allergy to tithing with respect to the younger demographic. And if that's all you got, if that's all you got is tithing and prosperity classes to kind of help coax more funds out of the community, well, the only people that are going to hear that message are the folks that are already doing that.
Yeah.
So it's perfectly fine for those who are stuck on in the word tithing to kind of say, we're not saying to change how you feel about your practice or however you want to do it. It's just organizationally, in the context of our evolving, to position ourselves in the way or in the river of cultural creatives, those who are in our are aligned with our theology, but not necessarily aligned with our demographic, because we're all old and we're stuck on these terminologies that create these sacred cows that we can't loosen up to allow some new people to come in and retool the system. So to the degree that you can help people sort of see, well, the larger issue is our resistance to something that's new and different, as opposed to us having to abandon something that is dear to us. We're not talking about that. We're talking about creating a spaciousness that can accommodate a different demographic if we're to survive long term.
Okay. So when you make when you use the word source, so tithing is giving to the place of your spiritual growth.
No, well, that's not what I'm talking about. The other way around. Source is not out there. I am
right. Source.
Okay, so
I'm giving back.
No, giving back is not a part of tithing as source. You don't give back, you give. You are the origin. Okay. I mean, it has nothing to do with what you're getting from your life in the context of tithing as source. What you have is your abundance, period. And so to give from what you have as source unto what you're trying to bless or to enrich is what we're talking about. It has nothing to do with what I get. And therefore, I have to, you know, share some kind of exchange. This has to do with who I am and my maturity for becoming something that is an agent of source. I am source unto my own life.
So because my life has been transformed in this community, for whatever reason, maybe it's spirit groups or whatever, so then I want to continue to be an avenue with which others could be transformed. Because I got it here, and I want others to have the opportunity to get it here as well.
Right. So you're not giving back because your life's transformed. You're giving back because you want more people to have what you have.
Okay. Very good. Okay, good. So then I've been explaining it right. That's what I wanted to be sure I was on target for that. Yeah. So we as a board, then, we currently tithe, you know, with the standard fare, Silent Unity, UWM, and so forth. So when we develop transformational partners that we want to write our monthly giving check to, how does that connect to source?
We give to them because of what we want them to become.
Okay.
Not who they are unto us.
Okay, very good. Very good.
And in these times, it's less about people getting something. It's more about what people are empowered to accomplish. And as we focus our funding model around the accomplishments of transformed lives and making the world a better place through the difference that people make, then we recontextualize why people are in spiritual community. We want more of this experience to happen for more people because the urgency is that the world needs to change. There's no unwillingness to really want to kind of evolve. And it's just that.
Yes, the willingness is there.
The older generation doesn't know how to do that.
Yeah.
They don't know how to kind of think in ways that kind of open up possibilities. You know, we're so conditioned to kind of rely upon moving away from our discomfort and towards what makes us feel better about things.
Yeah.
This is our condition.
And I fall right into that.
And so when we kind of recognize that some discomforts need to be welcomed because they're the very things that move us outside of our yesterday self.
Right.
And so let's now be in the discord of doing things differently and just be with it until we test some things out, get to the other side, and then feel like, wow, we've done this. And that might not be it yet, but at least we can see that, okay, that's the journey. The journey is accomplishing something that has yet to come forth, but needs to come forth in the context of what's needing to be birthed.
Mm-hmm.
And that requires of us the capacity to let go of every place that we're stuck.